doing a bit of cooking in the tent, and we'll bring some bits and pieces out, which we'll do in a minute. Testing out the stove for the first time in the Kyham tent. This is a Kyham Trooper 2. Very old tent, yeah, about 15 years old. It's actually the tent I singed the top. We used to camp at a double lock for the year. I'll go and pick out a couple of guy lines before I get on cooking something.
Right, well, this is the Optimus Polaris stove. I haven't actually used it yet for doing anything much in, apart from testing it, boiling water and trying out the different fuels. The multi-tool with the magnet on the bottom for cleaning the jet. A couple of adapters which I haven't used yet. And we've got one, that one there for the propane canister. And that one there, which is for the much cheaper pound canister. Well, there's the Optimus stove. So we could try out these canisters here, which is the Lindell, that's a Lindell valve here, which is the screw type that just screws straight onto there. But what I haven't used yet is the Bayonet adapter. Here, which screws onto there, and then the Lindell valve screws onto there. That's the first time that we've used these cheap canisters. These are only about £1 each compared with these £5 ones, which are ridiculously expensive. So, going to use up the rest of that canister. You're going to have to swap fuel sources throughout. Another nice thing about using the microphone is that you don't have to to shout. It should be all synced up. It's recording at 1080p, 30 frames a second, 120. And on the P10, 1080p, 30 frames a second. That's the last of that gas, isn't it? Invert it. You can flip the legs out like that. Flip the legs out on the bottom of the canister, and you get the last of the fuel out. Right, I think we'll get this. I'm going to get this in here. That's off. Well, the main purpose of that was to test out the adapter, and yeah, that was successful. What we're going to do now, test out the propane adapter. I haven't used yet. So check this out. I don't know if that's going to fit. Of course it will. Right, so the propane goes in there. Not used this before. There. These canisters are about 460 grams compared with the 230 grams of the other gas. And again, you can use that in liquid feed or gas feed, but that really needs to be a bit higher. So let's get that onto there. There we go, much more powerful. Propane. Hello, Dodge. There's Dodgy's here. Ah, that's better. Of course, propane is a lot better in colder temperatures than butane and some of these other gas combinations, because they put propane in these to try and help get the temperature, usable temperature, down. Make sure this isn't getting hot. It's metal gradient, but it's not getting hot at all, really. so much different cooking with this cooker than with a lot of the other ones I've got. Just the pan stays on the top are sufficient for a frying pan like this. And take the heat shield off, and it might be a bit better. Yeah, it's more stable. Pretty good flame control. With the liquid feed, like the white gas, petroleum basically, that will go down to much lower temperatures, which is what they use on mountaineering, or anywhere it's cold. Yeah, the only other thing I need, to get is a refill adapter which goes on the propane canister to refill this from the big propane canisters, which are much cheaper to buy in bulk. But what you have to do, you best put the little ones in the freezer for about an hour, and then invert the big one to transfer the fuel from the large one to the little one, and then you get a different differential in pressure, and it fills up properly. Otherwise, if you try and do it in the same temperature, you can end up with just transferring a little bit of gas, and that's all you get. So you need that. Need to do that to do it properly. Looking good. I'll get the rest in. Need a cover. I've put a cover over it to conserve the heat. Yummy. Peppercorn sauce. Sorry, say that again, it's a bit noisy in here. Okay. Ooh, lovely. No. Hang on. Come in. Yep. Okay. Share a bit. Yeah. You need a knife and fork. All right. This is the finished article. It's a bit of a mess on the plate now, but steak. See what it looks like. Yum. Really nice. No, I think that was a success. Apart from the fact that when I stopped recording for some. Ask Mum if she wants a bit.
Oh, do you want a bit? Yes, please.
Oh, right, we'll bring it in.
Okay.
Turn everything off. Right. I'm gonna go and share a bit with Zena. So, turn off.